Hi everyone! In this video, I want to show you how to create your own MCP server without any code. So what's an MCP server? MCP stands for Model Context Protocol. And an MCP server is basically a server that can host specific actions or tools that you can provide to an MCP client. An MCP client will most likely, in our case, be either a Claude desktop app, or could be in the future an AI agent to which you want to give access to a specific set of tools. I've been looking for a while for a no-code MCP server builder, and I finally found one. That's the one that the team at Pipedream has been building. So obviously they have a couple of them around. The reason why I'm really excited about this one is I know Pipedream has been a tool that we've been using for more than 5 years now. I know that they will handle properly my credentials, so I can trust them. And that's why I'm excited now to finally give it a go. So what I want to do today is I'm going to take a look at my Claude desktop and I want to connect it with my Stripe account. To do so, I just need to go here to mcp.pipedream.com. I look for Stripe. Here, I just need to connect my account that will guide me to the Stripe integration. Here, I have a little Stripe key ready to go. I can just copy my key here and then click to continue. I'm going to save this and connected. All right. So now I just have to follow the instructions. So configuration is set up. I have the MCP server URL. Here you can see treat your server URL like a sensitive token or password and do not share it with anyone. So this is very sensitive because basically anybody with this URL could just copy or regenerate here these instructions for their Claude desktop app. And they will basically be able to access my MCP server, so access my Stripe account. Let's see how this works. Now I head to my Claude. And basically you can see in the documentation from Claude how to do that, but you can go here, go into the settings, and then click developer section. You need to activate that developer section if it's not already the case. Then when I click edit config, it opens my Claude folder in my system. And here that's the only part which is a little bit technical. I open this JSON file. So for this, I like to use VS Code. And then here, even if you take a look at this, that's fine. You can click pause and try to look at my URL. I will delete it afterwards. So that's basically the configuration. I save this, I close this, and then I go back to Claude. I close Claude and I'm going to restart it again. It's gonna take a bit of time to load. All right, now I can see here, there's this little hammer that just appeared. And these 45. So 45 MCP tools are now available. These are all the actions which are now available on the MCP server that Pipedream has built related to some Stripe actions. So let's try it. Give me the list of the last 10 invoices created along with the creation date, the due date, the amount, the currency. Do not provide any customer information. We are recording the video right now. I need to be careful. And let's take a look. All right. So now you can see, I get a little prompt from Claude and it's basically asking me, and it's going to do that every time it wants to use one of the tools which is listed on the MCP server. So before it runs the tool, I need to give him the ability to do that. So I can allow for this chat, it means for the whole conversation. If Claude wants to reuse that tool, it will be able to do. I can allow it to do it only once. Especially it could be a good thing if it's trying to perform an action that has what's called a side effect. So if it's creating an invoice, if it's updating an invoice, sending an invoice, I don't necessarily want it to be able to do it without me confirming. In that case, I will allow this. I can also see here review what it's going to do. So here it's going to find all the invoices and providing one specific input, which is the limit of 10. So I can approve this and I'm going to allow this for the chat because I don't mind if it just goes and lists invoices. So now it's retrieving the information in the background and let's see what it comes up with. All right. Pretty nice. So this is actually accurate. Now let's try something else. Go and find all the transactions for the customers with the email piv@gonanext.com. I know I've been doing some test transaction in our Stripe account. Let's see how this goes. So now it's requesting some more information. So I can see here, so it's trying to list the customer and find the customer with that email. I'm going to allow this. And In a way, it's still pretty safe. So because I know that Pipedream is a trusted third party that will not deploy any wrong MCP servers or wrong actions, it's been pretty careful on how it's being implemented. I can trust the different actions, and here I can see also every time it's running one of these actions, I have the detail of which action it's running. I see the potential endpoint from the API it's using and the input it's giving there. So I can allow this. And here Claude is going to do a sequence of different actions. The good thing is basically the MCP server contains some information about the tool, so I don't need to tell Claude how to use the different tools. It gets this information from the server, and then it's able to leverage the actions to achieve the goal I given it. And in that case, I can see here, I indeed tried to get a ticket for our Builders Club conference, which is coming on June 25th. And I actually just generated a transaction for that, which I refunded. And that's the information that Claude found. So that's it. Just like that, in a few minutes, I was able to connect Claude Desktop and give it access to my Stripe account. Now, the great thing about Pipedream is that they provide a lot of different integration because they are actually an integration provider. I personally trust that they are storing in a safe way my credentials. I've been using them in the past also for client projects. So if you want to give it a try, most likely, this could be a good way to start playing around with MCP server as a no-code user. Be careful. This is a very new technology. And obviously, you know, don't share your MCP server URL and be very cautious, just like me. Once you share this into a video, make sure you just go and actually disconnect it. All right, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it.